Okay, so here's the landing page for the FSIS Northern Tier app. If you'd like, you can scroll through species alphabetically. If you prefer common names, you can go up to these three little lines at the top and choose a different manner in which to sort alphabetically if you're into common names. I prefer scientific myself, so I'll go back here. This was genus scientific name, but I'll go back to full scientific name. And then I can scroll down here. Let's say now I want to read a little bit more about one of these species. Let's pick maybe a really cool genus. Let's go down to Rhynchospora. Sorry, I'm not trying to... Okay, so now if I want to look at all of the Rhynchospora that grow in the Northern Tier, they would show up in this app. I can scroll through. Let's click on Rhynchospora cymosa. Can look through various picks. Let's say I want to just take a closer look at this image. I can click on the high-res image. It'll bring me to the FSIS webpage. And now I can actually zoom in and see the texture of these Rhynchospora achenes. So I'll go back to the app here. Nice feature there if you want to look closely at the picture. If I'm on the species page, I can go to basically the flora information where it talks about distribution, seasonality, habitat, maybe some taxonomic comments, and then the taxonomic synonymy. And a really cool feature here is this dichotomous key button below synonymy. And I can click on that and it'll actually show me precisely where Rhynchospora cymosa keys in the flora, which is really nice. And of course you can always scroll back to the initial key using this top blue hyperlinks. I can go back to the original Rhynchospora key if I'd like as well. So a lot of functionality there, and of course I can just go right back. This has at the bottom these illustrations you see that are partially completed. This is work in progress by our illustrator Kathleen Garnis. You'll see that these images and values correspond to our graphic key values, which I'll talk about in a second. As an additional thing, we also have the FSIS Flora, the Southeastern US maps that correspond to where this species is distributed. And because it occurs, you can see there in Virginia, west to Kentucky northward, it occurs in the Northern Tier. And of course, the map codes are there just as they are in the flora, if you're familiar with the Southeastern flora. So that's an example of one species tab. I can go back to home and it brings me automatically back to this menu. And you'll see the top there in blue is the filter. I can click on this. And let's say I want to be more specific about where I'm botanizing. Let's say I want to only look at, let's select none, and I only want to look at the Virginia Piedmont. I can click on that. I'll go back. And then of course, a lot of my options have been narrowed down at this point. So suddenly, if I go back to Rhynchospora, there's only a few options that are gonna be available. And even more so in the mountains. This is a genus, for instance, that is more diverse in the coastal plain. So it's a really nice feature if you want to be more efficient in the field and reduce your options. So I'll go back to that filter and just turn those all back on. Don't forget about that feature. Some people will often wonder why their species is not showing up, and it's because their filter is not reset. Okay. So that's just sorting around some basic dichotomous key features, images, and distribution maps. If you go to the right of the browse button at the bottom here, this is the graphic key. And if you want to hit begin, it will give you a little bit of a background on the various graphic key groups. If you are just eager to get into the functions of the graphic key, you can hit skip here. And it's set up where you basically choose what plant group you think you're looking at. So let's say, for instance, I know I'm looking at an orchid. At the very top there, it says 86 found. So that'd be 86 orchid species that are found within the Northern Tier app. So from here, I can then filter some of my options, and you'll see each time, let's say it's an orchid growing in wet soil, I've already lowered my option by 30 species. Let's say it's growing in full sun, it's now 43. I'm going to assume it's native. That looks like there's only one non-native orchid that is growing in a wet place in full sun that we got rid of there. By doing a pink flower, I've lowered my options significantly down to 7. So at any time you can hit show and it will, you can peruse your pink orchid options growing in wet soils in full sun. And let's say I just want to see if it looks close to Arethusa. Well, sure enough, I can click on it and say, oh yeah, I'm in the field and I'm looking at this actually kind of somewhat rare orchid in the southeast, that is. And even parts of the northeast. So it's kind of this cool feature. Again, you can click on the high-res image. If you want to look closer, zoom in on the lip of the orchid, look for various features. So if I go back to this graphic key, we're currently developing this nice feature that is called sort of our instant key. Well, if you have less than 10 options left, if you've been able to narrow down to that few, you can click on this and it will then take your options and convert it into a graphic key. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. You have the option to use more picture guides to get to your species identification. But then if you want a little bit more of a technical approach to identification, you can then convert to a dichotomous keys or a dichotomous key. And then here you can see the various genera or species that are within each of your options. And you can think, well, I know Cypripedium. I know this isn't what I'm looking at. So you can sort of deduce that 20B would not be the option and you can click 20A. So feel free to explore those functions more. As I mentioned, the instant key is a work in progress and we still have a little bit of code work to modify with that to make it a little smoother. So explore the graphic key more. We're also going to be supplementing more illustrations. And as you'll see, it's sort of separated by major groups. And you can read more about that in this initial menu if you hit begin. And it will describe those groups to you. And you can sort of figure out a little bit more of what's going on with the graphic key. Okay. This next option for dichotomous keys is separated by the large keys, master key at the top there, major plant groups like ferns, fern allies, so on and so forth. And then if I want to just go to, let's say, the maple family key, I can just click on that. And what's really nice is we have these various photos that sort of show a kind of flagship photo for this family and then sometimes secondary, tertiary, or multiple photos afterwards that show the diversity of forms within these groups. So if we take a family like, let's say, Amaranthaceae, and I want to go to the family profile, you can kind of see the various forms within that family, how those plants look in that group, and you can do that at the genus or family level. And then, of course, for species, we have almost all species with some associated photos. So this is a really nice feature if you want to just learn more about various groups. And again, you can do it for genus as well. Let's say I just want to look at, you know, how buckeyes look. Let's go to the genus profile. And I can say, oh, yeah, that's a very diagnostic photo of a buckeye. So that's kind of a nice feature. To learn diversity, to get more familiar with the groups in our area. And then the last function we have here on the bottom right is kind of our more menu. You can read all about the history of the flora and how we sort of have converted this data into the app that you're now seeing. So feel free to read more into that. Here's a map of the first flora, and you can see we do cover up to sort of the southern portion of Long Island, southern portions of Ohio, Indiana, and Illinois, and otherwise full inclusion of these other states here. Acknowledgements, if you'd like to see all the various partners and collaborators on this project. The great places to botanize. These are suggestions that many regional botanists have come up with for all of the 11 states in the first Northern Tier app, including DC as well. And scrolling down more, you can see, I talked about the family profiles earlier. You can just see more pics of this, and we're really grateful for a lot of the photographers who've contributed to these and have made these photos open access. We'll probably supplement more info into some of these morphological diagrams. And then, of course, we have a really in-depth text glossary, botanical glossary. And what's great about these terms is most of them are embedded within the keys. So, for instance, let's look at ABs. Here's a dichotomous key. You can see those blue terms there are direct links to those glossary terms. So if I forget what a bract is and I'm trying to figure out this key in the field, it will give you the definition as you key. So for the most part, again, I can always go back to my home menu up here. For the most part, everything can be reached at this bottom menu from the home screen. And we encourage you to explore these options more. And thank you for your purchase of the app, and keep in tune for more updates.